Hey guys, so today we are installing the van top rearview mirror camera. I gotta open it. So the reason I'm installing this is because I just bought a 2020 ProMaster that we're converting and has no back windows, and so it has no rearview mirror, of course, and can't really see anything. So the problem is that these cameras mount to your already existing rearview mirror, and since these vans don't have a rearview mirror, I might have to get creative with how I mount it. Here's what the box looks like. Yeah, the reason I went with this camera was the price was good, the reviews, and it's got super good lens quality, which is important to me, and it also has a front camera. Not that I'm gonna use it, but at least I'll have it in case somebody hits me or something. I also bought the hardwire kit because I want it to just come on automatically as soon as I start the vehicle, and I don't want to be like turning it on or plugging it into a cigarette lighter or something like that. I just want to feel like it's part of the vehicle, just like a rearview mirror. That's how I want to treat this, just like it's my rearview mirror, because theoretically it is. Okay. That was weird. I don't know how I'm gonna mount it. Yeah, see, no rear view mirror and no back windows. I might literally have to buy a rear view mirror just to mount this thing to it. That would be stupid. Well, I guess I'm gonna go get a rear view mirror. Alright, so I'm huge on not having any wires showing, and this is the rear camera, and so I'm gonna have to route this from the back of the mirror all the way to the back of the vehicle. I popped these little things off with just a flat blade screwdriver, and they've got a little Phillips head in there. I'm just gonna loosen those so I can get under that, run the wire under that. See kind of what I did. I thread the wire in from here underneath there, and I'm gonna put it on the back side of the screw so it's gonna hold it in there no matter what. All right, so that actually worked out perfectly. Put the wiring through there, ran it all the way up this side kick panel here, and I've got it here. Okay, so it was actually super easy. Took something dull, take something dull and long, shove it in there, and then just continue shoving the wire in this crack all the way up. And now here's where I've got it here. There's a perfect channel in there. It's like the exact size of the wire. So it slipped right in there, ran it across the top of this right here, the pillar, and now it's out there. And then it's gonna be ran all the way along to where the mirror's gonna be mounted. It looks like I got the perfect amount of length. Okay, so that is what it looks like. And that should be perfect for plugging in the mirror. Ran along the top here. You can see it sticking out barely right there. I'll have to tuck that in. Down the weather stripping, like I said, through here, here, around here. And then, right out here. And because I have the 159 extended, I had to buy an extension kit for the wiring that comes with the mirror, and so that's what this is. So it's actually the perfect length to run it through the dash and everything, and then from here back will be the wiring that came with the kit. So keep that in mind. I'll leave a link in the description for what I used. This is, I believe, a 12-foot extension. So just checking, I just got it set down on the back of the van, but look at that. That is like crystal clear. That's amazing. I'm super, super impressed right now. I just like made a mess and just plugged it into 12 volts just to test it. And it looks amazing. So yeah, that's good. Okay, so it's running from up there where I plugged in, goes down there. I'm gonna clean that up when we're done. And then it just goes in that seam between the wall and the floor. And you know, I'm gonna leave it like that for now, and I'll be able to test its reliability. If I have no issues with it, eventually, well, actually pretty soon here, this is getting wood floor, and so I'm just gonna cover it up because looks like a pretty reliable system. I don't think I'll ever have any problems with it. So ideally I would have been able to put it inside this wire loom here, but I couldn't fit either end inside where it starts. So I just ran it next to it and then electric taped it. It's not ideal. What I'll probably do is get a bigger wire loom and just wrap it over this one, just to protect it a little bit better, but it's gonna work out for now. So I need to, from this side, mount the camera, and I'm gonna put it over here so it's as close to a center in the door as possible. And basically this is where I wouldn't do this at home, unless you feel pretty confident in what you're doing, or you're okay with messing your van up, because I'm gonna drill a hole through here and waterproof it, and that's where the wiring is gonna run for the camera. So I'm not gonna get all particular with the sizing. You just need to make sure that your bit is big enough to push the wire through the hole. Okay, so back here is done. I was able to run the camera through, and the camera lead through, zip tied it to just the already existing to make sure it doesn't get tied up in anything. It's going through here and then all the way up front, and we're gonna go up there now. Double check that it's still working. Here's the finished product back here. Looks really good. We're just gonna make sure that it still works. It should come out automatically. Let's see. Okay. So it's on. Fantastic. You can even see how good that rain looks in there. That's crazy. So now we're gonna hardwire the mirror into the van. So this may be confusing to some, but I bought the van top hardwire kit, so it should work well with this system. Now, they give you a bunch of fuse taps, which look like this, and they actually give you three kinds. So it depends on what kind of fuse tap, sorry, four kinds. Depends on what kind of fuse tap your vehicle takes. And this Dodge ProMaster takes the micro fuses, or the mini fuses. And so what you do, this power wire here, the yellow wire on the entire wiring harness, you connect that wire to the mini fuse tap, and then you have to find a constant on fuse to replace this fuse tap with, and then that fuse that you pulled out goes into the back slot of the fuse tap. So it sounds confusing. Once you understand it, it's super easy. So now I've just got to figure out which one of my fuses is a constant on, and then we'll start wiring this up. All right, so if you've got a ProMaster, F38, which is the fuse box right there, which is really easy to access, is the only fuse in the entire fuse panel right there that's always on. So you need an always on fuse for the main power wire, and then the red wire is going to hook to an accessory, and that could basically hook to any of these fuses, because once the vehicle's on, all these other fuses will be working. So yellow's got to go to the central locking fuse. The central locking fuse is just the lock here, and you know, the vehicle's not on, and you can hear that it works. So that's always on. So that's what we're going to do now. Okay, so F38 is this blue fuse right here. They include this awful fuse puller. It's not really a fuse puller. It's meant for body panels. So yeah, just get that always on fuse out. Hopefully you have a fuse puller and you're not using a flat blade like me. You can grab your wiring harness. And that yellow wire is going to go in there. So according to the instructions, the fuse you pulled out goes into the bottom fuse slot of the fuse tap. They want you to also put a fuse that they provided in the fuse tap as well, and they're both 15 amps in this case. Like so, just like that. And then you're gonna put the fuse tap in the location that you pulled the original fuse from. Like that. See? Okay. What we're doing is the red wire is going to go into an accessory fuse, which only has power when the vehicle's on, so I'm choosing to use the passenger window. And we're just going to remove the original fuse and put that fuse in place. Basically, the only thing we have to do now is ground the wiring harness. So I have it set on a piece of bare metal. I'm just going to test that the insulation went okay. So I'm unplugging the 12 volt plug, and I'm going to plug in our new power source. So obviously it's working. Make sure that the passenger window still works. Okay. Okay. So like I said, I really don't want to have any sign that this was installed. The only thing that I can't hide is this box here. It doesn't really look like it's for the mirror, obviously. I probably could pop this panel and put it in there, but I'm just going to use double-sided tape and put it right there. It just looks like I'm being tracked by like the CIA or something. So that's fine. Yeah, just gonna button up the van, and then I'll walk you through it one more time and show you how it works. Okay, one more time. The install is entirely completed. So, mirror, the cords are running, the power cord and the rear camera lead are running at the ceiling and front windshield threshold, down the driver's side pillar to the fuse box, inside that kick panel, down underneath the driver's seat, connects there to the extension. Comes out here. That's the only wire that's visible. It's bothering me. I hate seeing wire. The good thing is I am getting that piece here that's going to cover the like the trim piece. So anyways, that will be covered. Then just runs along the side of the van where the floor of the van meets the wall of the van, which is also going to be covered once I floor it. And through here, alongside that wire loom there, and then into the back here, out to the back.